Hey, hello YouTube, I'm Karan from India, and in this video we're gonna talk about an awesome batch plugin that I just have created and updated. It is the button function version 2.0, and using the get input plugin by Akini, I have made it much more advanced than it was previous, and it is now much easier to use because I'm getting feedback from one of my pal, Mr. Pepertronics, that the usage is quite complex of the button function. So in this version, I am reducing the effort and amount of work by the programmer. The function itself does all the work, and it will be quite easy and simple to use this plugin. So without any more talks, let's directly jump into the plugin. So here the button function is of 5 KB of batch plugin, and it uses these much amount of batch functions that are 4 batch functions, out of which get input and batch box are 2 awesome things that are making it much more advanced. So before talking about how to use it, let's see the amazing output on the CMD console. As you can see here, there are a lot of buttons on the console. I have created approximate all color combos that are possible with batch colors. So as you will etch over on these buttons, they will change according to that, and now you can check which button is clicked. So if I will click on button 5, it is saying button number 5 is clicked. So button number 11 is clicked, and you can detect the button click, and the mouse edge over makes it much more advanced than it was before. So this is my special color combo. I like this combo because in this method here, we are just inverting the colors. Because if the text color is in the button 3, if the text color is black and the background color is that color cyan, and if I will edge over it, it is inverting the color. So now the background is black and the text is cyan. So but in my that special combo, what I am doing is I'm just reducing the color intensity because it is F0 before without edge over, and after edge over it is 70. So it is making user more comfortable than this sudden change in the edge over. So let's talk about the code, which is quite smaller. Let's open it in Sublime Text Editor, and now as you can see here, we close other things, and as you can see here that a simple code, then there is a loop, small loop. What we are doing is clear the screen and the changing the background color, and here like the button function version 1, we can also give button function version 2 multiple buttons in a single go, and it will print all the buttons instead of giving the code for the button. In this version, what we are doing is we are taking the X and Y coordinates for the button from the user, and the text and the color, only 4 parameters. We have removed all the unnecessary last 2 parameters, and there is no logic in generating the code for the button and user will print it, because it creates a lot of mess in the main code. So here what we are using is we are asking the user to provide the X and Y coordinates for the button to print, and after that we are taking that input and generating buttons and printing on the console. And but how many buttons you want to print doesn't matter, but after the last button that you printed, you need to specify X, because X is the terminating character here. It will tell the function that the sequence is stopped and there are no button options available now. You have printed all the buttons necessary. And after the X, you need to write 2 parameters, the name of the 2 variables. So here in the box, like in the menu bar function, here in the box, The button function is returning the area of the button in this variable, and pardon me for that, in this variable the area of the button, and it is returning the h over color of the button in this variable h over. You can use the box by the slash m command of the get input and slash h command the h over. So here what I am using is I am displaying the last button as my special button. So here I am reducing the last three points, last three characters from the h over and adding a 70. You can also create all the buttons with the same color, just remove this. It is not mandatory to use this variable, but the function will provide you this variable, so it's up to you if you want to use it or not. Here in this case I'm not gonna use it and I'm going to save it. Let's see what the output now. So all the buttons are generated, and when you will h over it, so all the buttons will be have the same h over color, but the non h over color will be different. So it seems quite nice than the previous output. So if I will click on button 15, it will click button number 15 clicked, and this button should be 16th button, and yeah, it is 16 button. So all you need to do is you need to know the sequence in which you have generated the buttons and printed them, and you must assign them IDs. So button 1 has ID 1, button 2 has ID 2, so that when the getInput function will tell you that which button is clicked, and in the error level variable you can use that ID compare that which button is clicked and do according to that in your main code. That's all for now. I hope you like it. Feel free to subscribe. Thanks for watching. Please share this video with your friends. So bye bye.